This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video will have two pieces to it. The first slide will cover the standards that are described by the IMA and their Statement of Ethical Professional Practice. And the second slide will discuss the standards that are presented by the IMA related to how to resolve an ethical conflict. So we'll start here with the four standards that were described by the IMA. And by the way, the IMA stands for Institute of Managerial Accountants. So the IMA says that we as accountants must have competence, meaning that we must maintain an adequate level of skill to perform the duties that are required of us. And so this may require going out and getting what's often called continuing professional education to make sure we're on top of the latest laws and regulations. The second standard relates to confidentiality. And here the IMA says that accountants must not disclose confidential information for any reason, unless of course we're legally obligated to do so. The third standard is integrity. And here the IMA states that we must avoid any conflict of interest, including the receiving of gifts or favors, and that we must not do anything that would discredit the profession. The fourth standard is credibility. The IMA states that accountants must disclose all relevant information fairly and objectively. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, this video covers the IMA's recommendations should we encounter an ethical conflict. There are several approaches that can be taken if we find ourselves as accountants in an ethical bind, and the order of these really will depend on the situation, but we'll go through these to make sure it's clear that there are lots of options. First of all, the IMA recommends that we follow the organization's established policies. So if we're asked to do something as accountants that we think may be compromising to us and to the organization, we need to check to see if the organization has a policy in place that will help us to resolve the conflict. The second item that the IMA recommends is that we discuss the ethical issue with our immediate supervisor, unless, of course, this person's involved. If the supervisor is the one asking us to do something that is perhaps unethical, we would need to then go, thirdly here, to higher management, and that might include the chief executive officer, it could include the chief financial officer, perhaps the audit committee, which is typically a subset of the board of directors. Perhaps we go directly to the board of directors. The IMA also suggests that we discuss the issue with an IMA ethics counselor. The Institute of Management Accountants actually has a hotline that we can call, and it's anonymous. We can discuss our issue and see if we can come up with some possible solutions. The IMA also suggests, depending on the significance of the event, that we consult with our attorney. Oftentimes, the attorney can give us advice that would really help in resolving the issue. Ethical issues are rarely resolved easily, so these are some suggestions that the IMA has for us, but there may also be some other avenues that we consider to be appropriate. One thing that the IMA does not have in their literature but might be appropriate is to resign from the company and move on to another company that we feel more comfortable with.